So this video is not suitable for all the students across the world now struggling with studying physics or arts or economics on Teams or Zoom or Skype, and whose teachers are expecting them to excel with less resources and a faulty internet connection. Because in this video I will talk about the wonders of school and how the surge in access to education globally has transformed the world. And less about the tedious hours you spend trying to learn the periodic table of elements, and why the school lunch tastes like fish, even though the menu says curry and rice. This is on average how long the adult population of China has stayed in school. 7.8 years. In neighboring Japan, it's 12.8. In Congo, 6.8. And in South Africa, 10.1. In Brazil, it's up to 7.8. In the US, it's 13.4. And Germany tops the list at 14.1 years. And while education can be a source of financial burden as a result of high tuition fees, only reachable for the most well-off in society, or a state-run, slowly moving institution with computers from the late 90s, or a fiercely competitive, stab your friend in the back, only the top percent gets in kind of struggle that you desperately want to reach because otherwise your parents disown you. But education is, jokes aside, generally considered a worthy investment and a driving force behind social and economic development, especially when it's of good quality and accessible for everyone. This is what the world map looks like today. Population above 25 in the nations marked in blue have attended school for more than 12 years on average. Green, between 10 and 12 years. Yellow, between 8 and 10 years. Pink, between 6 and 8 years. And red, below 6 years. Even though many nations in Africa delivers an average education of more than 6, 8 and even 10 years, most of the nations in red globally is located on the continent. On this map, we use the same colors, but also mark the numbers of years vertically. One marker equals 1 year in school on average. Starting in 1950, most nations have numbers below 1 year, or between 1 and 2 years. Only South Africa and Namibia, known as Southwest Africa, under South African administration, have numbers above 2. This map follows current-day geographical divisions, and nations without markers lack sufficient data. Starting time, we can see the development taking place, and the drastic change over the last 7 decades. The development and investment in education is in many of the African nations more rapid than in, for example, the European nations when they were at the same level. In this graph, we can see the development in a few selected nations during the same time span, from 1950 to the latest figures. This visualization shows the proportion of world population who are literate versus illiterate. The population older than 15, who has sufficient reading and writing skills, are marked in blue, and the rest are marked in red. We start in 1900, when almost 4 in 5 adults in the world were illiterate. Today, that number is down to 13%. So overall, we are doing rather well. You might object to the increase in years in school spent in the richer parts of the world, and the financial aspect of putting a whole population through 15, 18, 20 years of schooling. And of course, the quality can always be discussed. And we will have a difference of opinion on whether this or that field of education is worthy of its price. But overall, I'd say it makes our societies prosper more. Of course, there are still great challenges out there for the poorer nations, like how to decrease the dropout rates, how to increase the enrollment in secondary and higher education, as well as how to increase the quality of education and reach the rural population more sufficiently. Some nations must also work on the incentives for the educated population to stay and not move abroad for better economic and social opportunities. But looking at the middle and the low-income nations, the development since the turn of the millennium is staggering. It is important to note that this holds true for girls as well as for boys. 30 years ago, 86% of boys enrolled in primary school globally, and 77% of girls did the same. Today, those numbers are much closer together, and they're both over 90%. There are still challenges to women's education when it comes to dropouts when reaching puberty, and the lack of access to higher education, or an inability to combine school or work with parenting, especially in some parts of the world. But the picture today is so much brighter than 15, 30, or 50 years ago. And we know, especially when it comes to educating women, how impactful it can be for both her children as well as her whole community. If you want to see me visualize more statistics like this, feel free to subscribe to my channel. I have some more interesting topics coming up in the near future.